Hey, what's up? I'm Maker from YouTube.com, and welcome back to another very exciting YTPMV tutorial. Today, we are going to be creating Shurikscan inside of After Effects. Nah, just kidding. So this is just going to be a quick tutorial for how I usually handle syncing up my video with the audio inside of After Effects without doing a lot of work. So I could just go from having an audio file and in a few minutes to having this. With very little manual work behind it. So yeah, let's get started. So to get started, first we'll be creating a MIDI that will then import into After Effects. And with that MIDI, we'll be able to sync up the video flipping with the audio. And you can use pretty much any DAW that uses this. I'm just going to be using Reaper because that's what I'm most comfortable with. And I'll also be using this pre-existing audio by Beat Shoban. Shouts to Beat Shoban. Alright, so let's get started. So we're going to come over here, right click, insert new track, insert new MIDI item. We're going to go into the properties of this by hitting F2 and turning off loop source so we can extend this as needed. Double click into this. And this is going to open the piano roll. And by default, it's going to have this pencil icon and you're going to be able to change the length of the notes. But we don't really need to do that. We're just marking where you want the flip. So we're going to come up to this diamond icon, click on that, and that'll just create these single beats, essentially, that we can place down. And also make sure you have snap to grid turned on by hitting Alt-S or hitting this magnet icon up here so you can make sure everything's lined up properly. So we're just going to start placing these with the audio. And if you want to preview this at all, to make sure these are lined up correctly, we can add an effect to this track called Resynth, which is just built into Reaper. Turn down the audio. I'll just play it back and see if it's in time with it. So yes, from here you just place down the notes and then we'll move on to the next step. Alright, so when you're done you should have something like this. You can again use that effect to make sure the timing's correct. So from here, we can close that menu. We'll just go to File, Export Project MIDI. And you'll have to set up these settings depending on your project, but in this case, this is just pretty simple one. It's just 6 seconds long. We can do entire project, selected tracks only, and choose you want to save it and hit OK, and that should be it for the MIDI. So now from here we'll move into After Effects. So in After Effects we're going to create a new comp, drag in our audio, trim this down. And to import our MIDI, we're going to use this script by Omino, which I'll have a link for in the description that you can download from their webpage. So to run that script, we'll go to scripts. And if you're running it for the first time, you'll have to choose to run script file, but I've already ran it recently, so I can just use recent script files. It'll ask you to choose your MIDI. I'll hit apply. And that'll create this null object with these three keyed parameters for pitch, velocity, and duration. And the only one we'll need is duration, so you can delete these two for pitch and velocity. And what you'll be left with is that MIDI that we created from Reaper with those notes that we can then use to sync up our video with the audio. So to do that, we'll then take our video with the sample that we want to use, make a new composition from that, clip it to what we need, and we'll just rename that to stay organized. So back in our main comp, we're going to drag that new comp we just created in here. And we're going to use two expressions that I'll also have a link for in the description. One for the time remap and one for the transform effect. So we're going to right click on the layer, go to time, enable time remapping. Take our first expression. I'll click on the stopwatch, paste it in. And for our second expression, we're going to add the transform effect. Uncheck uniform scale, alt click on scale width. And we'll take our second expression, paste it in there. Extend this out to the length of the composition and then mute it as well, so we don't get the audio from the original clip. And this is what you should have. So if you're curious what's going on here, we have two expressions, one for time remap that is taking the previous keyframe on our MIDI layer, and it's just taking the time since that last keyframe. So from here, it's the beginning of the clip, and once it hits this keyframe, it then resets itself the use that as the starting point, and then this as the starting point, and so on. And for the width, it's essentially doing the same thing, except we're just checking if it's an odd or even keyframe, and then it'll flip it accordingly. And the really nice thing about this is that by pre-comping your sample, it's really modular if you want to edit it to like add extra animation to it. So if we wanted to like change the scale for each sample, for example, we can just animate that right here. Just add scale keyframes. Easy ease this. Animate it. Add motion blur, why not? So just using this one comp for the sample, then that'll propagate into this comp for each time it flips. And that's about it. So this is a really easy and modular way to get your video synced up with your audio in After Effects with just a few steps. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to leave a comment below. And as a side note, I'm thinking I'll probably do more tutorials like this in the future. So if you have any tutorials you might want me to do, you can leave a comment about those as well. We'll see what style I'll make them in, if I'll do more like this, or they're more open-ended, or something more streamlined. So yeah, that's about all. Thanks for watching.